Hey there. Who wants to talk about taking breaks today for mom? Who wants to talk about mom taking breaks? I definitely do. So I'm so glad that you want to schedule those into your calendar as well because they have been life-saving for me, and I'm really excited to talk to you about that today and help you schedule those in as well. So why do we need to schedule breaks? Why is this something that I'm excited about and something that I feel like is important enough to do its own Facebook Live about? I could just talk about schedules in general, but I think that scheduling breaks is a really good place to start when we're setting our schedule up. That's the way that I like to set up my schedule. I figure out what breaks I want to take first, and then I schedule around my breaks how I'm going to do everything else. So I was told yesterday that maybe I need more breaks than other moms because I'm a single mom. Most of you know that. I'm a widow. And so maybe I need to take more breaks than other moms because I'm with my kids 24/7, literally in the middle of the night. If my 9-year-old has a stomach ache, she's in the bed with me. So maybe other moms don't need to take as many breaks as I do. And I would say, no way. I think that all the moms need breaks. I think that homeschooling is a challenging occupation. It's rewarding and challenging. And I think that it is exhausting. And we all need those breaks. So even if you're not a single mom, I think you need breaks too. The main way that I got to start to believe in scheduling breaks and taking breaks, committing to my breaks and sticking with my break schedule is that year that a lot of you know about. Where I went from homeschooling 3 kids to homeschooling 6 kids in one school year. And I was so freaked out. You can't even imagine. I just walked around the whole summer with my eyes bugging out of my head. I just didn't know how I was going to do that. I was losing my mind in stress and anxiety. I was excited to do it a little bit. I knew it was going to be a challenge and I was up for the challenge, but honestly, I really didn't know how I was going to not die. So I know that some of you might feel exactly the same way and know exactly what I'm talking about because you're either homeschooling for the very first time this September or you are adding kids into the mix that you already have. And anytime we add kids to the school year, add kids, add the number of students that we have, we feel that stress all over again, just like the first time that we homeschooled. I don't know why it works that way. I think it's just the uncertainty of not knowing how, something new, something different is going to happen, and we aren't exactly sure how the school year is going to go. So we get those butterflies and that little bit of anxiety, just like we did the first time. So that was me about 3 years ago, and I was panicking, and I heard that people take these regularly scheduled breaks, and I just said, sign me up. How does it work? How can I fit this into my life so that I'm not going to die? So I really want to share that to you, especially if you're having that feeling of how am I not going to die this year? And I'm going to tell you exactly how to do that. There is a little bit of a burnout factor throughout the year too for homeschoolers. If you decide to just start school September 5th, let's say the first day after Labor Day, and then school 180 days straight through the year. You do 5 days a week and you just go, 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 go. I think, and I've seen it happen, there's a high risk of burning out in the middle of the school year and just losing your energy and losing your will to homeschool. That's when moms start to say, I think I should put my kids back in school. Why am I doing this to myself? There are other options. And I really truly believe that having the regular break schedule and committing to taking it keeps you from having those feelings and keeps you on track and always gives you something to look forward to. If there's a break coming up that you can hang in there for and look forward to coming. So I want to talk about besides, I just said why you need breaks, but the kids need breaks too. I want to talk about how to schedule them. I want to give you some ideas for some classic break schedules that people use. And I want to talk about taking breaks inside of our homeschool day too. It's not just the first thing I'm going to talk about is the overall school year and how you can take some really nice breaks in the school year. But I also like to take breaks for mom during the school day. To pace myself and keep my energy up as the school day is going on as well. So hang in there for that because I think it's really, really important. But the one thing I talk about breaks all the time, and I've been talking about taking breaks for years to moms, and I get a little flack sometimes, or people think it's a good idea, but they don't actually do it. And then the next year, they come back to me and say, I think this year I'm actually going to do it because I really needed to do it. So please believe me, just try some version of a break schedule this year and you will not regret it. I don't even know why anyone would regret it. It's wonderful. So I'm just going to encourage you to go ahead and do that. But the other thing is that it's not just mom who needs a break. The kids need breaks too. And this can be a little bit tricky. It depends how old your kids are, how many you have, and kind of the academic abilities of the kids. But I find as soon as we started taking breaks, because I wasn't sure, and our breaks are 1 week long breaks, which you don't have to take if that seems really, really long. I'll talk about that in a second. But our breaks are 1 week at a time, and I was worried that kids would start to lose some of their knowledge in that time or some of the skills that they had learned. And it never happened one single time. And in fact, after a nice break, some of my kids came back as better spellers because everyone came back with a little bit more rest under their belt, a little bit better attention spans, and the break that I scheduled for myself because I didn't want to fall apart and die, turned out to be a wonderful break for the kids too, and something that they could look forward to as well. Yeah, keep that sanity in check, Nels, definitely. So now what I do is I take those breaks, the normal 1 week long breaks that we always took, but I have one kid, this is the key, he's 7 years old, he's still just getting his, he reads, but he still needs to stay on track with his reading. We still do his reading 20 minutes each day. We're in the summer schedule right now, the summer break, and he still has to do reading every day because even though we look forward to the break and it's so exciting and I need a break, he would fall off the wagon with his reading and I don't want him to go backwards. So in certain situations, you might want to take a shorter break or you might want to just have the one student stay on track or a couple students just stay on track with one thing and it still feels like a break from school. It's still refreshing. It doesn't feel like you're having your whole entire school schedule going on. But I want to talk to you about how to actually schedule them in and give you some examples of how you might do that. So I made the mistake a few years ago of recommending this to every single person on the planet, and I still am, but I was telling everybody about the break schedule that we take, and it doesn't work for everybody. You need to have a break schedule that works for your family. If you have little ones, which I don't, so I take long breaks, you're going to want to take shorter breaks, more frequent, shorter breaks. And if you have older kids, like my kids are 7 to 13, you can take those week-long chunks, and I'll tell you how we do that in a second. And that's going to be great for your family most likely. And if you need to keep one kid on track still during that big break, you still do that. But when you have littles, you know what I'm about to say. They need you to watch them all the time. So if you have a week-long break, all you're doing is run around chasing the little kids. It is not refreshing to you at all. But if you have older kids and they have things, they have chores that they can do, you can make them catch up on housework. My kids say that during breaks they have to play Cinderella. But that's how we catch up on housework around the house too, like the deep cleaning. But with the little kids, you might want to take more frequent, shorter breaks. So let me give you some examples. A really, really common break schedule, and you might not be thinking of this as a break schedule, but schooling 4 days a week instead of 5 days a week. So every single Friday, Saturday, and Sunday is a break. And people do that year round, typically. So you might take 2 weeks off for Christmas and maybe 2 weeks off for summer, but the whole entire rest of the year, you do something like Monday through Thursday, or I know I said it was Friday, Saturday, Sunday off, but it could be Saturday, Sunday, Monday off. The whole entire year, you stay consistent with that. Oh yeah, Nels is on. She does that 4 days a week and it works out year round. That's really, really common. And I know families love it because it keeps the energy level. It keeps everything kind of even. And it keeps everything moving forward. And you don't lose any of the knowledge. All the retention is there and you just kind of keep chugging forward. and putting one building block on front on top of the other as you go. Then some moms prefer to do 3 weeks on, 1 week off in their month. So every single month they have 3 weeks of school and then 1 week off. A lot of moms who work do this, or they do 4 weeks on, 1 week off, where particularly if they're business owners and they need to stay on track or they need to catch up with work for their business, they will do this, and they'll do this year round. So if you're someone, I know this year we probably have more moms who are working moms homeschooling than ever before, because you were kind of thrust into homeschooling. If you're trying to figure out how you are going to work or keep running your business while you homeschool the kids, you might want to do something like this, where every single month you've got 3 weeks on, 1 week off, or 4 weeks on, 1 week off. And that might help you catch up with business that has fallen behind a little bit, or help you catch up on the housework because that's fallen by the wayside while you're trying to work and school. So something like that might work, but that's really common. A classic Charlotte Mason schedule. So if you were a Charlotte Mason homeschooler, which is a type of homeschooling philosophy, and you wanted to stay on the traditional 1860 Charlotte Mason schedule, that is 12 weeks on and 1 month off. So that's year round. And that's, oh, Nels, your comment is very long for me while I'm talking. I can't read it all right now. But that's 12 weeks on and one whole entire month off. So you have a 12-week term, and it's typically the months off are April, August, and December if you were doing a traditional Charlotte Mason homeschool. And thousands of families do this schedule, and they absolutely love it. In my mind, I feel like one day I would like to do that, but I like the schedule that we have, and I'm going to stick with it for now. But I also like that schedule, so maybe one day I'll give it a shot. But that seems like you can kind of hang in there for 12 weeks and then just kind of regroup for an entire month. And that sounds really enticing to me as well. And then we follow, I'm sure some of you have heard me say this before, we follow a Sabbath schedule. And that's 6 weeks on and 1 week off. That's just the little nickname of it. And I particularly like this schedule right now because, and we've been doing this for a few years now, because you always know their break is just around the corner. When you're 4 weeks into the school, it seems to us like I can always like feel that 4 weeks have passed. And I'm like, okay, we only have to go 2 more weeks until we have a break. And the kids have that in the back of their minds too. And you can always kind of hang in there for 6 weeks. The same with the 3 week on, 1 week off, 3 week on, 1 week off, and the 4 week on, 1 week off. You can always hang in for that amount of time and know that a break is coming, and that's great. And that's really what the other thing we do, I'm sorry, we take a long Christmas break. We do 3 weeks for Christmas break, and then we do about a 10-week, 8-week, 8-week or 10-week summer. But I live in New Jersey where we have absolutely no state guidelines and regulations. So we do about 174 days of school. I know some states require 180, so you have to go with what your state requires. We don't have any requirements here, so I do take a lot of breaks. It's not that different than 180 days, but it's a little bit, it's 1 week less. But one of the things that having these regularly scheduled breaks helps you do is hang in there. So before I was taking scheduled breaks, of course I was taking breaks left and right because I would be exhausted and I didn't really have anything to push through to. So if I woke up and my kids were a lot younger, they didn't need to stick with their schooling every single day. If I was exhausted, we had a day off. Or if the kids were having a bad day, we had a day off. You know, and we just took them here or there or anywhere. And then that leaves you with a sense of not really knowing how much schooling you're getting done. And it doesn't feel great. It feels like things are a little bit out of control, a little bit willy-nilly. I don't like that feeling. Some other people might be okay with that. That makes me very, very uncomfortable. And it's just not consistent. And you're just never quite sure. When you're just going with your feelings, which I don't like, things just don't feel secure. They don't feel good. So it's really great to actually schedule that time in, and then stick with it. So I gave you. I'm going to talk in a second about scheduling breaks in your day, but I just want to stick with the calendar for right now. with the school calendar for the year for right now. I gave you in the comments of this post, if you're watching the replay right now, or in a post today, there should be a PDF of a blank school calendar. What I do is I print about five of those out and I start with the breaks and I say, okay, if I were going to do, like if I were you and I had never done this before, I would say, if I were going to do 6 weeks on and 1 week off, what would that look like? And I kind of scratch it out and see if I can make that work. And I would say, okay, what would 4 weeks on and 1 week off look like? And kind of figure that out. And then I would say, what if we took every single Friday off? What would that look like? And just see how it lines up with the holidays that you have, the birthdays that you have, the regular vacations that you want to take. And I would just, if it doesn't work, rip it up, throw it away. And everything's trial and error on those pieces of paper. And I just start with the breaks first. So the warning that I need to give is that when you start taking breaks, if you decide to do these long 1 week, but I'm calling them long, they go really fast. If you decide to do these 1 week long breaks throughout your year, which is, they feel great. They feel very refreshing. It feels like just the perfect amount of time. Don't expect them to feel like a vacation, though. So I think that's the key. I'm calling them breaks, and everybody gets excited about taking breaks. And I feel like I led my friends astray for a couple of years because they would take these breaks and not be that excited because they didn't feel like vacation. You're hearing break and you're thinking vacation, and this is not sipping Mai Tais on the beach. You're still at home with your kids, so let's be real here. But it's a change from teaching school. And if you haven't started homeschooling yet, if you're starting in September, you're going to see right away that there is a feel to the school year when you are teaching school. And then there's a, when you don't have to teach school on any given day. So what you're looking for is a change and not a vacation. So it's a break from teaching school, but it's not. You're still in your house with your kids and you still have your household chores. You're still cooking dinner every night. So please do not get mad at me if you start taking breaks and it doesn't feel like a vacation. It's not going to feel like a vacation. You still have to have the structure of your household and cleaning your house and all that kind of stuff. I'm burning up time here. I want to talk about taking breaks for mom inside of the school day. So the kids need breaks, so let's just start there. They do need breaks in the school day. If you have little ones, they need potty breaks and snack breaks. They might need a break to jump on the trampoline and get their energy out, or run around the house, or stretch. It depends what level of energy, what level of ADHD, we have a lot of that in this house, they have, and what needs to go on during the day for their breaks. And when I'm talking about breaks for mom in the day, for the kids, it might be a 10-minute or 15-minute break. That is not what I'm talking about for a mom in the day. If you want to try taking those little breaks or sending them out to the trampoline for 15 minutes and that's your break, you can try that. That's great. I need a little bit more than that in the middle of the day. And again, people have commented to me that maybe because I'm a single mom, I need more of a break than other people. And maybe that's true. But just try this on for size if you need a break too. I do a really long, really decent hour and a half break in the middle of the school day. it's our lunch and our recess. The kids have to go outside. They even go outside in the snow in the winter and whatever's going on. They put on snowsuits and they ride their bikes in snowsuits. They go down the slide on the playground in snowsuits. They go outside and leave me alone. But I need to breathe. And I just need to respond to emails and texts. I need to put a load of laundry and move it through. And I need to put a load of dishes in, stuff like that. Because when I'm doing my, and this is going to be key for anybody thinking about how they're going to homeschool during the year. When you're sitting down to school your kids, a lot of times that stuff is playing on the back of your mind. And it's distracting you from being present and being focused on the one-on-one teaching that needs to be taking place. So I used to be thinking, ooh, I can fold my laundry while I teach this kid, or let me just run over here and empty the dishwasher and yell to them across the kitchen, like, oh, you got, reading a less, telling them how to do a math problem or something like that. And that was really keeping me, it was slowing down their education, and I needed to get that stuff off my mind and off my plate. So I gave myself a break during the day where I could get those things done and not think about them again. Now, you could take your break earlier. If your school day only goes till 12 o'clock, you could take a little break before that. If your school day is really, really short, don't worry about it. Maybe you don't need a break in a school day, but some of us do. If you have a lot of kids, you do. If you are overwhelmed, you do. And take the kind of break that you need, because I made a mistake for the last school year. I scheduled for myself a 15-minute break where I was supposed to go in my room and close and lock my door. I put it on my schedule and I was like, you have to do this every day to refresh yourself. I was still teaching six kids last year. And I never took it because it's not the kind of break, it's the kind of break I thought that I needed, but it's the kind of break I don't like. And I really just needed to go and do the dishwasher. I know it sounds silly, but I needed to get that off of my mind. I just needed to be kind of in my space, maybe listen to a podcast while I did that, and that was enough break for me. So think about what kind of break you actually need, not what you think it should be. Think about what kind of breaks, what length of breaks you need during the school day or the school year in the overall calendar, and think about the kind of breaks that you personally need that work for you during the school day. That's going to help you when you're looking towards September right now or August, whenever you start, and you're worried about it and you're like, how am I going to live? How am I going to survive? Please just get some breaks on the schedule for yourself. Just start off with your breaks, schedule everything else around your breaks, because you need to be healthy. You need to keep up your energy. You need to be strong. You need to be mentally in the game. You've got to keep going for the whole school year, and everybody is relying on you. So please think about yourself, schedule those breaks, and I hope this was helpful. I gave you a blank daily schedule that you could work on. Again, I would print like five of those out and scribble out some options, crumple them up and throw them away if they don't work for you, and try a different one. But just figure out where you can take little breaks for yourself. So I hope that that is encouraging and you think about yourself a little bit more than you normally do when you're planning out this school year. I will talk to you soon.